Finally got my hands on the UM790 Pro from Minisforum. They sent this out to me, of course, and no, this is not a sponsored paid review at all. I've got the 32 gigabytes of RAM spec here with 512 gigabyte SSD. You probably already know the specs if you're watching this video, but it's a very potent little mini C because it has that Ryzen 9, the 7940HS. It does have a lot of potential because it's got the Radeon 780M graphics, which is, up until now, well, it's the best when it comes to integrated graphics. And I'll be going over this in detail to let you know why it is the best of the Ryzen 9 7940HS mini PCs. So what is included with this mini PC? Well, there's a little card here that's warning us not to disassemble the CPU cooler because they've applied a liquid metal to this and you don't really want to be touching that at all. And this is a user guide, so that just goes through a few different things in different languages, safety information, setting it up, how to get into the internals. You see here we have just a couple of new little feet there if you did need some. So they've got two replacements, that's great. Some screws here, this is for the VESA mounting bracket. It does not support 2.5 inch drives. This is our HDMI cable. We've got a power cable and our power supply. Now this power supply here, if I take a look at the rating of it, it's rated to 120 watts, this particular model. And good to see it's using a standard barrel connector. So it's basically like a laptop power supply or a gaming laptop power supply. And finally, we have a VESA mounting bracket. This model does not lack on ports, which I really like to see. So we have four type A USB 3.2s Gen 2. We've got 2.5 gigabit LAN and two HDMI 2.1s. Good to see. A lot of brands just put HDMI 2.0 and just rely on then the Type-C ports with video out to cater to 4K 144Hz or 8K. Now that's our power in, obviously, there. So at the front of it, we've got two USB 4s. So they're the full spec. They're 40 gigabits per second, support power delivery, and that's video out up to 4K 144Hz, and you get 8K 32 with those. So really good. So you can run four monitors with this particular mini PC. 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, reset there, power button with status LED, and the vents either side, nice and large. And what I like about this unit here is this. There's a little cooling fan inside to keep the RAM cool, the SSDs cool, and some of those components. Now, some of the units I've been reviewing with the same exact spec, so the same RAM speeds, the same APU, the Ryzen 9 7940HS, did not have this, and they ran into problems with just randomly rebooting, RAM overheating, and other issues. So to gain access to the internals, you just need to remove these rubber feet on the bottom. They're stuck on pretty hard, but with a little bit of pressure, you can get those off. So four screws here, and you'll see we do have the mounting holes there for the VESA mounting bracket. With those four screws removed, there's a little gap here that you can just put your fingernail in and pull up. Now be careful because there is a wireless antenna that is here, and we have another cable. So a little tricky right now. I will need to unplug those, and then I can show you how we can upgrade this unit. Just this fan needed to be unplugged, and it's this plug right here. You can see there is our RAM. So I have 32 gigabytes. Each one of those sticks there is 16, obviously, and the speeds are 5,600 megahertz. This is our Kingston SSD. So both of the slots here, you can just see the other one there, M.2, 22 by 80. They're both PCIe 4.0. And yes, you can run RAID 0 or RAID 1 if you wanted to. Now they've got the heatsink right here for those SSDs is really large. That's the fan that's going to be keeping it cool. And we even have some little heat fins here and a bit of a cooler for the RAM, which is great to see because, as mentioned, some of the other units, the RAM was getting really hot that I saw with some of the other mini PCs running the same chipset and spec because there's a lot of power in such a small package here. Now, because it's got liquid metal applied and because I always want to have the factory paste job or application, I'm not going to go any further with the teardown. Unfortunately, I know some people will be disappointed, but I want to retain that. So we have my thermal results being exactly how it is, how you get it out of the factory. So just under this, you'll find the Wi-Fi card, which is Wi-Fi 6E. So very easy to add another SSD to upgrade the RAM up to 64 gigabytes maximum, and you can add or set up RAID 0 if you want. Now this is new here, the BIOS setup. They're now using a visual BIOS and not the old traditional BIOS menu setup, which is a bit different here from them. So you have the boot options, you got the
UEFI shell and BBS menu, or just to straight away go and boot. Now you would click on this boot here once you save your changes. So in setup, this is where we have some interesting settings. Under advanced is most of the stuff you'd probably be interested in. So we do have hardware RAID you can set up. So you can set up RAID 0, RAID 1, and power configuration. Now by default, it's the balanced mode. So this is what I will leave it on. You can set it to performance mode, which will use the fan a little bit more, and it will probably be a little bit louder, of course, but maybe a bit more in terms of performance. I haven't touched that. I have not experimented with that either. AMD CBS. So there's some settings in here that I do like, and this is under NBIO common options. Go into graphics configuration. By default, it's 2 gigabytes dedicated to the 780M, but you can tweak this and adjust it right up to 6 gigabytes. Again, I'm leaving it on the default. You can also set this game optimized, which will boost the performance a little bit. I believe it maybe it might actually tweak the power limit as well, but I'm just going to keep it all default here for this review. Security, boot there options. Okay, that's all pretty straightforward. So it's really those settings are the useful ones. So once you save that, you get out of it. You want to save here too as well, but I'm not going to do that at the moment. I exit without saving, and then you just click on boot to go into Windows. Here we are in Windows. So we have a Windows 11 Pro as our version, not home. And there is 2 gigabytes dedicated to the Radeon 780M graphics, which for integrated graphics is right now the best really that you can get when it comes to APUs, mini PCs. It's better than the Iris Xe graphics. Now looking here in the device manager, just very quickly show you a couple of things here. So you see that the APU, it's listed 16 times. That's because it has 18 cores, 16 threads. The maximum turbo is 5.2 gigahertz. And the disk drive, it's a Kingston. So they're using Kingston RAM and Kingston here for the SSD. Now it is a PCIe 4.0 SSD, but when you take a look at these speeds, they're not really that impressive. It's only the read speeds that are slightly higher than PCIe 3.0. Now, of course, if you want faster than this, get yourself something like a 980 Pro. You can also run RAID 0 if you wanted to do so. That would double your storage, also increase your sequential speeds significantly, but you have that risk of if one of those drives has a bit of a problem or something, you lose all of your data. But normally it's pretty good nowadays with that. So looking here, just under a few other things I wanted to show you, that general performance is very good. I have no issues with this unit. The multitasking is very quick. And so far, the fan noise has been absolutely brilliant compared to other units, especially with the same chipset. So single core score here for Geekbench 6 is impressive. And so is the multi-core score there. So with those 16 threads, that's really good. And they've picked up the single core scores with the 7000 series compared to the 5 and 6000 series, which was a little bit behind, especially behind Intel. So that's an impressive performance here, and you just notice it. Everything you do is very quick. Cinebench R23, so getting a score of almost 16,000 for the multi-core score. Again, considering the size of this mini PC, that's a lot of power for such a small unit. Single-core score there is also impressive, nearing up the 1,800 points there. Then a couple of synthetic benchmarks here. This is Time Spy that they are actually comparing on their official website, saying it performs about that of a GTX 1650. It is in fact under. So 3,200 points puts it around about 400 to 500 points less than the GTX 1650. But still, for integrated graphics, that is a very good score. It's impressive. So is the CPU score, just over 11,000 points. And the Night Raid score here, almost 30,000. The graphics score nearing 35,000. So this is the test that they do recommend for integrated graphics, and it is pretty much the same as all other 790 40HS mini PCs that I have covered, getting similar kind of results. Demanding video file playback is handled by the integrated graphics really well. So this is HEVC 140 megabits per second 4K. See that it opens up, it doesn't drop any frames. It shouldn't. It seems to be perfect to me. So it's at 60 frames per second, looking really great, no issues. And a 4K 60 frames per second file, this is also very, very good. No problems. The start is like in slow motion. Skipping ahead, I don't see any problems at all, any lag. You can see, okay, it did drop a couple of frames, But most of the time it's running at 60 frames per second. So it's really good. Those two or three frames that it drops was just me resizing the video, which is normal, and you wouldn't even notice that anyway. Demanding work like 4K video file editing here with Adobe Premiere Pro. This is the latest version, 2023. Now you notice the timeline with just a quarter playback resolution. This is fine. There is no noticeable lag or issues. It feels not quite that of a dedicated GPU. Now, if I had a dedicated GPU running this, it would be just a little bit smoother, but it's getting close. It's almost at that kind of level. And it certainly does feel a bit faster here than some other mini PCs I've been reviewing, just moving about within the timeline here. Now, the export times, because there's no Intel Quick Sync, which Adobe Premiere Pro does favor, I expect this to be not quite as fast as the RX Xe graphics, but we'll see what happens because they have made a lot of improvements lately, Adobe, when it comes to AMD chipsets. So 1 minute of footage, and I will set this all up with the YouTube preset. So there we go, about to finish up, and you can safely say that that was probably about 26 seconds. So that is very good indeed for encoding 1 minute of footage at the YouTube preset here with Adobe Premiere Pro. And you're probably most interested in this, which is gaming performance. So I start out with the most demanding game here. This is Cyberpunk 2077, 720p on the lowest preset. And look at this frame rate. It gets up to 70 frames per second in some places, but most of the time it is over 60 frames per second. This is so good. It's enjoyable. It's playable. Yes, I would love to have a higher frame rate, but I think for a game like this being so demanding, this is very impressive just to see this kind of performance out of integrated graphics only. Fan noise, I can barely hear the mini PC. It is so good. And the temperatures, as I showed you before, it's pretty good. Gaming, it's in the lower 80s and it stays there. It doesn't start to creep up or anything like that. So I am really impressed with how well it runs such a demanding game like Cyberpunk 2077. Grand Theft Auto 5, so this is running really well, around 100 frames per second, depends on what area I am in the map. And you'll notice that there's a tiny little bit of throttling happening. Now the clock should be, the maximum is the 2.8 gigahertz, and it does drop down a tiny little bit. Now the thermals are excellent, they're in the 70s to the early low 80s, and for medium settings that I'm running, and 1080p, this performance is fantastic, getting over 100 frames per second. Now, if I was to be testing this out with the same settings with Iris Xe graphics, 96 executional units, then you would be looking at about 70 frames per second, 60 in this area of the map. So that is the kind of boost we're getting. Not quite double, but it is an impressive boost in performance. And for integrated graphics, this really is the best you can get at the moment. Finally, for gaming tests, The Witcher now 3. This is the patch 4.0, which is the big patch. Now, this area of the map is really demanding, especially at night now with all the lighting and the textures, the shadows and everything has got to work out. So the frame rate is at 720p here, lowest possible settings, playable because it's around 60 frames per second. Ideally, I would like more, but I can tell you this is so much better than the Iris Xe graphics that I've recently been testing out in this area of the map. Around this time, it's only getting about 30 frames per second, which feels choppy. It's not really great at all, so this is a lot better. So here, I think it's safe to say this is probably double the performance of the Iris Xe graphics with 96 executional units. That's how good this Radeon 780M is. Now, if you'd seen my other videos on the Ryzen 9, the 7940HS mini PCs, they all had issues, right? They would reboot, they'd be overheating, they'd get up to 90 degrees, RAM would hit 95 degrees, and as you can see here, RAM temperatures are good, 63.8 degrees Celsius. The CPU side of things, yeah, 79.4 degrees, this is excellent, very, very good. In terms of temperatures, I don't see any issues with this unit, and I've had no random reboots, I've had no sudden power cutting off and causing issues, which I did with the first 7940HS mini PC I looked at. Now the fan noise is excellent, you barely hear it, it's very quiet under idle, and even under load, doesn't make a lot of noise, and here's a sample of it under full load, testing out Cinebench R23. And finally, just very briefly, Linux support. I know a lot of you do ask about this. Good news here, because everything seems to be working. I tested out Linux Manjaro, open source drivers. It found the Wi-Fi, the Bluetooth, volume, audio, all seems to be working, including the USB 4 ports, video out that I was using here to capture the screen. So that is great news when it comes to Linux support for the UM790 Pro.
And what else can I add to this review? Well, I did test out power delivery with those two USB 4 Type-C ports at the front. And yes, it worked. It didn't cut out. I managed to run Cinebench, no problems at all. That is good. So the mini PC checks out in basically all areas. The fan on the bottom is one of the best things yet, because that solves the issue of the RAM getting too hot, the SSDs getting too hot, other components getting too hot. Thermals, as you saw, very, very good. So it's not thermal throttling, it's not running into any issues. Unlike the other models I reviewed from GMK Tech and B-Link, they would randomly reboot. They had just problems with the thermals. Eventually they started just getting way too hot. This, no. I've been pushing it really hard now for a couple of days, gaming, testing it out, the benchmarks, 4K video editing, and it is a solid offering from them, so that's really good. There is only one thing I can complain about with this unit, and that is I ran into some issues running 4K at 120 Hz through their two HDMI 2.1 ports. Now, originally I thought it was my cable, I thought it was my fault. I tested some other cables, and sure enough, it eventually happened. And that is, the screen will cut in and out for a second, it goes black, then the image comes back at 120 Hz. It is very annoying. Using the Type-C ports, the USB 4 ports, with 4K 120 Hz, it didn't happen then. But those HDMI ports should not do that. I don't know why this is happening. Perhaps it's a BIOS issue, hardware maybe, or could be drivers or something else funny like that. The other thing is, well, there's no room for a 2.5 inch drive in this unit here, unfortunately. That's probably because they put the fan and the cooler in there. The cooler to cool the heatsink there for those SSDs. And I think that's a welcome trade-off. At least we do have another M.2 full spec PCIe 4.0 bay there, well, drive that you can install another SSD to expand your storage. So this, I think this is the best yet, and certainly so much better than the GMK Tech one that I reviewed that had issues with the thermals getting too hot, B-Link's random reboots, other issues. So that's why this one gets a big thumbs up from me here from Minilink. And no, this video is not paid, it's not sponsored. They've just sent me out this unit and it's passed all my checks, running it now for a couple of days with zero issues. Fan noises too, absolutely fantastic. And it was a bit of a surprise too to see Linux was all working. So thanks a lot for watching this review, and I'll hopefully see you in the next mini PC review.